frequency mode.
Hi guys, this is Jordan here from RSM Overland and welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to mount your Baofeng UV5R in your car. It's gonna be easy, pretty straightforward, and most of all, you won't have to drill anything in your dashboard or any plastic trim in your car. Stay tuned. Okay, so I'm gonna do the install of this pretty well-known small radio with you today in my vehicle. This is a Subaru SF5 Forester, but actually you will be able to do that in every kind of vehicles. It doesn't really matter, Tacoma, 4Runner, Land Cruiser, Crosstrek, Outbacks, really, it doesn't matter. And in order to mount this little bad boy here, I went with a solution I tried and I approved. This is NSM Overland approved. I went with another RAM mount, but this one is a little bit different than the one you used to see.
So this is the typical RAM mount you will see everywhere. So this is the X-Grip design. This is the large version for my phone. So that's a bit different than this one.
And this one also have the X-Grip design, but as you can see, it's way smaller to fit the Baofeng UV5R. And underneath you also have kind of their ball system, but you can't actually remove it. And some kind of a weird mount here. And I will apply a sticky thing here, a sticker. Double-sided sticker. And the name of this little cute mount is the RAM Lil Buddy Mount RAM X-Grip Holder. And you can find it on the RAM Mount website at rammount.com. And as you can see, it perfectly fit the Baofeng UV5R. This is the perfect size, doesn't move at all. You can actually also use the tether with it to secure it even more. The only thing you want to do before installing it, as you can see, I don't have the clip on the back of the radio because it will interfere with the mount. So you will have to remove the pocket clip of your radio. But it's gonna be stationary on the car, so that's not a problem. And since the purpose of all of this video is to have, you know, more convenient, better comms in the car, well, I also went for this kind of mic to use with the radio, the Baofeng. It's gonna be just easier to use while driving. And now that we have all the elements to mount our onboard Baofeng UV5R in the car, all we have to do is find a nice spot. There are many, many options. I'm gonna show you some of them, but also I will show you the one I choose and I will tell you why.
So first of all, I could have put it here on the dash with my phone. The only problem here is that it blocks the view like a lot. My phone is already big enough here in the middle of the windshield, so I didn't want anything else here. And also I will have to run the mic with the cable, so it will have been, you know, in the way, in the middle. So not a good option.
I also see some option here in the center console, but I actually used this part here to store some stuff, so it will also, you know, interfere with the stick shift. Here I don't have any place for it, and here I have actually the storage here. I'm using it, and here this is actually our secret stash for our computers and all the cameras and stuff. And we need actually this space between the seats. Yeah, you'll see it's in the way, so not a good option for me, and I think for every SF Subaru owners here. I thought about something else, like somewhere here. I'm totally not showing you this awesome fuzz operator keychain available soon next Monday on my website. But actually I also saw some setup here, you know, like this. But during long trips I like to move my legs like in every space I can, and it will have been, you know, not really convenient and really annoying actually to have it here. And I thought about the same position but on the other side, somewhere like here. It would have been great, but it's the same for the legs actually. There are also a lot of people who set up their navigation tablets, comms, radio on the passenger side, and that's actually an awesome place for it. As you can see, it would have been perfect. But if you watch my videos, you know that I really, really often go on adventure with Lisanne, my girlfriend, and she's already mad about her space on this side. So I'm not gonna bother her with, you know, a radio setup on her side. So here is the spot I found, and that is my solution.
Just right there. It will allow me in the first time to run the stock antenna. I think it's not pretty good, and I will look for, you know, real car antenna I will have to put on the roof. And here it doesn't interfere with anything. It doesn't block my view, and I think that's the perfect place. And also I'm gonna run the mic and the cable along this plastic trim here, and then put the mic here on my Molly Sun visor organizer. That's gonna be great. I'm gonna show you how to make the cable here flush so it won't move everywhere and block your vision. And now we're gonna install the Lil Bud RAM mount here on the dash. Stay tuned.
And when you buy the Lil Buddy mounts, you're gonna have in the package, obviously it is double-sided adhesive thing you're gonna put here on the mount and then on your dash. And also this little alcohol towel to really clean especially your dash, but also the Lil Buddy mount if needed. So we're gonna do that right now.
It's a bit dirty.
Just a little bit to make sure. All right, so it's nice and dry now, so we're gonna apply the adhesive patch here. Just like that.
It's also dry here, so I'm gonna put it right there. I'm gonna remove this side. Now I'm gonna apply a lot of pressure on it for some time, because as I said, the board of the dash here is kind of curved. Getting it nicely tight, nicely glued all around.
Yeah, it's actually better results than what I expected. The mount here is nice and flexible, so it really fit the dash nicely. That's awesome.
Look at that. Got the radio mounted, the Baofeng UV5R on the RAM mount, Lil Buddy X grip.
That, my friend, is the perfect solution to mount your radio.
Perfect. Look at this. This is my point of view here while driving, and you can barely see it. I mean, it's just perfect. I'm gonna try to find an antenna to put under the roof of the car.
So guys, if you have some nice reference, some nice antennas for Baofeng UV5R to put on the roof on the car for a better setup inside, but also for better reception emission of the radio, I'm all ears. Please, in the comments, give me some names, give me some links. I will be happy to have your help on this one. Thanks, guys. The radio is here on the dash. As you saw, it's a pretty easy operation. It's just an adhesive pad to put, and you can actually mount it everywhere
on the dash. The base is flexible, so if it's curved or something like that, it's not a problem. And now what we have to do is to put the mic and like set up the cable so it won't bother us while driving. Let's do that. Okay, so first we are gonna plug the mic to the radio. Up, it's nice and connected. A little tweak I'm gonna do here with the RAM mount is actually to get the cable behind the rubber here, behind the arm. So it will be a bit better. Let's do that. Just like that. Okay, it will be enough for some people, but for me, it's not quite enough. And what I want is really to fit the cable up there, like this. At least on top. So I really thought about it. I wanted to do it without any drilling, without any permanent modification to your car, especially the interior. And I came up with something I found, you know, and we always have a little box with a lot of screws, bolts, you know, all kind of junk we never use. And I found this thing. I don't really know what they are and what the original use for them. There's just little hooks. I got two of them. And actually, I'm gonna put these hooks on the plastic trim. I will show you that right now. Okay, so we're gonna do something like this and put the hook pretty much like this in order to get the cable through it, like that. So it will hold it against the plastic trim. All right, guys, abort mission. I repeat, abort mission. I just realized something, that instead of running the mic all up there and, you know, getting annoyed by the cable along the plastic trim, I have a better solution. Actually, it will be perfect to run the cable down and to simply put the mic here. This will be a way better cable management rather than stretching him all the way up there. And it's also an easy place to use it. I think that's way better. So if you want maybe your mic up there, you have the solution along the plastic trim with the little hooks. You just have to put them. And what I wanted to do is use just a pair of pliers and squeeze them just enough on the plastic so they will be strong enough to support the cable and a little bit of tension. But actually, I won't have to do that. I'm just gonna find something to hook the mic, because we have a hole here to put something. And once again, I'm gonna use some double-sided tape and boom, it's gonna be done. That's absolutely awesome. I love when, you know, you have a project in mind and when you're here doing it, everything's changed. So I'm really happy with this second solution. I think it's even better and it will look better. So let's go for it.
Problem.
Solution. So in order to put the mic in this other position, a bit lower on the dash, I'm simply gonna use some Velcro and double-sided tape. So I'm gonna apply some pressure for a while. That's it. We'll be right back. Alright guys, so that is our final setup. I really hope you enjoyed the install of the onboard Baofeng UV5R using the Lil Buddy RAM mounts. As you saw, it's really easy, straightforward, absolutely no drilling. We didn't damage any plastic, we didn't damage the dashboard, and that's a great thing if you want to keep your interior pretty much stock. So that was a nice solution I wanted to share with you guys, because I did some research actually for that and I didn't found a lot of useful information. So hopefully this will help. And now that the radio is here on the car with us for our adventure, let me know if maybe you want a full video about the Baofeng UV5R, maybe how to set up it, how to use it. If you're looking for this kind of information, please tell me in the comments and maybe I will do a video about it. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel, it's always help. Also, don't forget to check my Instagram account for awesome pictures and my website, which is full of contents about my build, aka the Tactifoz. And if you want to contribute a little bit more in a different way, I also have a Patreon page. And speaking of that, thank you to Jerry from Norway who upgraded his pledge, and it really, really helps in like that, okay? So thank you guys for watching and see you next week.
NSM Overland, out.